Hello friends, today in this video I am going to show you how I insert keywords in the 7 keyword boxes. The method that I use to insert the keywords in those 7 keyword boxes is based on a full-fledged research, so you are going to find a lot of valuable information in this video, and I am also going to show you how to rank your book for that specific keyword that you are targeting. So make sure to watch this video till the very end. So before starting to learn about inserting the keywords in those 7 keyword boxes, you need to know about the two very important terms. The first term is called indexing and the second term is called ranking. When you search for a particular keyword, let's say for instance flower coloring book for adults, you will come up with certain number of searches shown by Amazon. So for this instance, there are around 7000 search results for the keyword flower coloring book for adults. Now these are the number of books that has been indexed by Amazon for the search term flower coloring book for adults. So if you have got a book with the keyword flower coloring book for adults, your book might be ranked at 30th place, or it might also be ranked at 5000 place. A research done by Kindlepreneur has shown that if your book is ranked at first place for a particular keyword, then it has got an overall probability of 27% of getting clicked. Similarly, if your book is ranked at second place, then it has got an average click-through rate of 12%, whereas 9% for the third place, 8% for the fourth place, 7% for the fifth place, 6% for 6th to 10th place. Similarly, it goes on decreasing as the ranking does the same. So this research has clearly shown that your book needs to be ranked in order to get clicked, and without getting clicks, you are not going to get any sale. So it is very crucial to rank our book for the particular keyword rather than getting indexed for various different random keywords which our book will never be shown to the audience that we are targeting. So here are different facts that you need to know before inserting your keywords in those 7 keyword boxes. The first fact is that Amazon rearranges the keywords that you insert in the 7 keyword boxes. So let's say for instance you have inserted deep blue whale in one of the 7 keyword boxes. So what Amazon does is Amazon will rank your book for each of the individual words along with the combination of different words that you have inserted. So for the example given above, what Amazon will do is it will rank your book for each of the individual words, which is deep, blue and whale. And it will also rank for the combination of two words, which is deep blue, blue deep and various other combinations of two words. And it will also rank for the combination of three words, which is deep blue whale, deep whale blue and other combination of three words. So you have to take into account this fact while you are entering keywords in those 7 keyword boxes. And the second fact is that the more number of words you put inside the keyword boxes, your book will be indexed for more number of keywords. But the more words you put inside the keyword boxes, the lower your rankings will be. What does this statement mean? To understand this, let's take two different scenarios. So let's say in the first scenario, we have inserted in one of the keyword boxes coloring book gifts for men, women, teens and kids. And similarly, in the second scenario, we have inserted coloring book gifts for women. So Amazon will rank the second book higher for the keyword coloring book gifts for women than the first book, but the second book will not be indexed for the keyword coloring book gifts for men, kids and other various combinations of the keyword that the first book has got. So what this fact tells us is that inserting random keywords that is irrelevant to your book will actually hurt your rankings. So it is totally useless to do that. And what this fact tells us is that you have to leave 2 to 3 boxes for inserting long tail keywords, and you are not going to insert anything except the long tail keywords that you are targeting for your book. And the next fact is that you have to avoid using pluralizations of the word. Let's say for instance you have got a word cat in one of the 7 keyword boxes. So make sure to avoid using cats or any other plural form of the word that you are using in your 7 keyword boxes. And next thing is avoid using commas and unnecessary spaces. This is just a waste of space. Also avoid using the metadata that will potentially lead to misleading customer experience, such as using names of various popular authors and using various keywords like best-selling book or any other stuff like that. So avoid using that. And the next fact is that repeating keywords just in the hopes of ranking your book for that particular keyword in your title, subtitle, and in the 7 keyword boxes is totally irrelevant. So if you have got your long tail keyword in the subtitle, then you can leave that keyword in those 7 keyword boxes. And talking about repeating the keywords leads us to our next fact, and the next fact is that Amazon will prioritize your keywords that has been entered in a specific order. So what does this statement mean? So let's say, for instance, in one of the keyword boxes we have inserted a keyword deep blue whale. So your book will be ranked higher for the search term deep blue whale rather than it will rank for any combination of words found by these three words. So your book will be ranked a lot lower for the search term blue deep whale or any other combination than the search term deep blue whale. So you have to consider this fact while entering the keywords in the 7 keyword boxes. So you have to make sure that your keywords are written in proper order. And the next thing that you need to keep in mind while inserting the keywords in the 7 keyword boxes is that in some instances you might want to repeat your keywords. So let's say, for instance, you have done your keyword research and come up with two different keywords. The first keyword is Christmas gift for co-workers and next keyword is gag gift. So these two keywords has got the same word gift in both of them. So in this case, what you need to do is use the word gift in both of the cases. As we said earlier, Amazon prioritizes the phrase in a particular order. So you might want to consider repeating some words if the word complete some phrase that you are targeting. And the next fact that I'm going to share with you is that the keywords used in the title has got a lot more potential to rank than the keywords used in the subtitle, and the keywords used in the subtitle has got a lot more potential to rank than the keywords used in the last 7 boxes. So using all of the facts that we have utilized, let's fill the 7 keyword boxes for the keyword research that we did on the previous video. So as you can see, we have collected some list of keywords here in the past video. I will provide you the link down below in the description tab for the video so that you can check the entire keyword research process and how I came up with all of these keywords. And here is the list of final keywords. This list is based on the different facts that we discussed in this video. So as you can see, here is some space in this first box to insert some characters, and I have left it blank because I wanted to make sure that this keyword is highly relevant and there is no any other words to hurt its relevancy. So I have done the same for the second long tail keyword here, and I have inserted these two boxes by targeting the audience whom the books is going to be used by the keyword research that we did in the earlier video. And similarly, these are the keywords that describes the physical attributes and various other things about the book, and these are also taken from the keyword research that we did. And this is the final keyword box which contains the related terminology, and it also contains remaining keywords that we might have missed. So I hope you enjoyed this video. So if you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. And as always, thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.